Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll demonstrate a new capability in ACE version 13, which allows you to access details about different parts of a message flow using a context tree, which is a new tree that has been added to the message assembly. A message assembly is a logical representation of a message being handled by the message flow at a particular point. The flow in the picture shows the physical XML message that was sent into the message flow and the physical JSON message that was returned. But each of these messages have a logical representation called a message assembly. In ACE version 13.0.3 and earlier, the message assembly was made up of four trees: the environment tree, the local environment tree, the exception list, and the message tree. The message tree contains a properties tree, message headers, and a message body. Since ACE version 13.0.4, we have now added a fifth tree called the context tree, and have added further capability in version 13.0.5. The context tree is not captured by default. The context tree is only made available when it is referenced in the message flow. The context tree can be accessed using the ESQL compute node, the Java compute node, and using the trace node. In addition, the discovery connector nodes use the context tree when mapping inputs. In the example, there is an ESQL snippet which uses the context tree. The context tree has information about how the message flow was invoked and context information from every message flow node earlier in the flow, including payload details. Consider the message flow on this slide. I have a breakpoint after the compute node. When I stop at the breakpoint, I can see the context tree in the debugger. It shows details of every node earlier in the flow. There is only space on this slide to show the details of the HTTP input node, but details for the two REST request nodes can also be accessed. In the past, you may have used the environment tree or the global cache or an ESQL shared variable to access data from earlier nodes in the message flow. By using the context tree, you no longer need to use these other methods. So now I'll take you through how to use the capability. I'll start from an empty workspace so that you can follow along and try out the capability yourself. I'll start with importing a REST tutorial which contains two example REST APIs. So I'll open the tutorials gallery and I'll search for REST. And if I scroll down, there is a tutorial called Aggregation Nodes Using REST Async Request Nodes with Backend Services. This is a useful tutorial to use because after I import the projects, you can see there are two backend REST APIs. First, I'll start a test server. Okay, so I have a test server started, and now I'll deploy the two backend REST APIs. So I have backend 1 and backend 2 here. So now I'll create a new application and I will call it Context Demo App Simple. And now I'll create a flow. And in the message flow, I'll start with a HTTP input node. And I'll add a HTTP reply node. So for the HTTP input node, I'll add a path suffix. I'll call it context demo. And I'll set the domain to JSON, as I'll send a JSON message through. And now I'll add two REST request nodes, which will each call the backend. I'll I'll need to specify the OpenAPI document, copy this location, and select a REST request node. I'll specify the URL. I'm using localhost. And it's found the OpenAPI document, select the operation, click finish. Each of these backend REST APIs take input and convert it to uppercase. So the input is sent as a query parameter. So I'll pass in a value for the query parameter. And now I will get the OpenAPI document from the second REST API. Create another REST request node. Again, I'm using localhost. It's found the API. I'll select the operation. And click finish, and again this API converts the input data to uppercase. So I will provide a value for the query parameter, which is used to pass into the operation. That's my two REST request nodes done. I can wire them up. So now I'm going to add a compute node. And my compute node is going to take the data from the HTTP input node and the data from each REST API and form a response from those three pieces of data. And I'll add a trace node as well, so we can see the trace. So now I'll open the compute node and I'll show how to access the context trees. So I'll just get rid of these sample procedures. And in my compute node, I'm going to create some JSON output. So I'll define that the message needs to be sent out in JSON. And now I'm going to set up the response message. So I'll use set output route. .json.data, I'll call it name, and then I'll do control space as a new keyword called context, and I can select nodes. The input node is called HTTP input, and I want to get the payload and then access the data. And under the input message will also contain the name element. And now I'm going to access the data from my two REST request nodes. I'm going to do the same thing again. Output.json.data, and I'll call it string 1. I'll call it context.nodes. And the first REST request node is called getBackend1. And I will select payload, data, and the output of the REST API has an element called output1. So if I put a dot there and do a control space, I can see that I need to select output1. And now I'll get the output from the second REST API. So this is called getBackend2. So set the payload.data, and the second API has an output called output2. So if I do a control space, I can see output 2 is listed. So content assist has been useful there for me. So I've created the ESQL to form the output message. So I'll save that and save the flow. So I can now use the flow exerciser to send in a test message. So I'll send in a simple test message. So I sent in an input message and it's received a response message. And it contains data from an input message and data from each of the two REST APIs. And you can see it has uppercased the data from the input message into the output message. So I can look at the message assembly. I'm looking at the message assembly after the compute node. And you can see there's a new tree there called context. It has a section called flow details and invocation details. And there's a node section. Under the nodes, you can see it lists HTTP input, get backend 1, get backend 2, and compute. For the HTTP input node, I can see the payload. I can also see the headers. So I can see the HTTP header information, and I can see the metadata, which gives me the URL. For the two REST APIs, again, I can see the output data that is returned. And this is much easier to access now than having to copy data into the environment tree or using an ESQL shared variable. So that's using the flow exerciser. I didn't actually update the trace node, so let's have a look at writing to a file. And so specify the path of a trace file. And put in details for the pattern. Notice for the access to context tree, I have to use $context. Save that. So let's deploy the application. So I've redeployed the application. To message through the flow. We can see the response. And let's refresh the test server. I can see the trace file now. And in the trace file, I can see the context tree. So let's add a breakpoint after the compute node. And let's launch the debugger. And let's put a message through the flow again. Let's stop to the breakpoint and we can see the context tree can be seen in the debugger. You can see the various nodes in the flow. You can see the input nodes and the two REST request nodes and the compute node. And you can access all the context information for each node. So you can see the payload data, you can see the header information, and you can see the metadata as well. So in this video, I have shown the new capability in ACE version 13 for using context trees, and I've demonstrated how you can use them